Department works closely for business community.
She feared becoming an object of ridicule.
There are varying approaches to plagiarism across different university departments. It is within the framework that we're making our survey. The timetable will be posted on the website before the class starts. It is interesting to observe the development of language skills of toddlers. Students should book a library tour on the first week of the first semester. I guess the only way to make up for all the lost time is by doing overtime. If you have a driving license, getting a job would be easier for you. In the winter, it gets harsh. But it won't be an issue since there is a heater.
The brain is basically built from the bottom up. First, the brain builds basic circuits that are responsible for basic skills. And then more complex circuits are built on top of those basic circuits as we develop more complex skills. Biologically, the brain is prepared to be shaped by experience. It's expecting the experiences that a young child has to literally influence the formation of its circuitry. It's built into our biology. The interaction between genetics and experience that shapes brain architecture is embedded in the reciprocal relationship, the relationships that children have with the adults in their lives. And by that, we mean what we refer to as the serve and return, the nature of children's interaction with their and adults' development, and the impact of experience on development is not a one-way street, it's a back-and-forth interaction. The brain is a highly integrated organ which has multiple sections that specialized in different kinds of processes. So we have parts of the brain that are involved more in cognitive function and other parts that are involved in processing of emotion and parts involved in seeing and hearing. So, if a child is emotionally kind of well put together and socially competent, that will affect more positive and productive learning. And if a child is preoccupied with fears or anxiety or is dealing with considerable stress, no matter how intellectually gifted that child might be, his or her learning is going to be impaired by that kind of emotional interference.
A non-governmental organization, NGO, is an organization that is neither a part of a government nor a conventional for-profit business. Usually set up by ordinary citizens, NGOs may be funded by governments, foundations, businesses, or private persons. Some avoid formal funding altogether and are run primarily by volunteers. NGOs are highly diverse groups of organizations engaged in a wide range of activities and take different forms in different parts of the world. Some may have charitable status, while others may be registered for tax exemption based on recognition of social purposes. Others may be fronts for political, religious, or other interests. The number of NGOs in the United States is estimated at 1.5 million. Russia has 277,000 NGOs. India is estimated to have had around 2 million NGOs in 2009. Just over one NGO per 600 Indians, and many times the number of primary schools and primary health centers in India. NGOs are difficult to define, and the term NGO is rarely used consistently. As a result, there are many different classifications in use. The most common focus is on orientation.
How do you describe the line that divide a circle into the same half?
What kind of liquid do mammals feed their babies? What kind of liquid do mammals feed their babies?
When something is given in a pair, how many of them are there? When something is given in a pair, how many of them are there?
How many sides does a pentagon have? How many sides does a pentagon have?
What's the color of the medal that a champion gets? What is the list that shows the names of actors and actresses in a movie?
What device is used to measure a 200-meter sprint?
Fruits are protected by their skins. Then what is the hard object in the center of peaches, apples and pears?
What kind of clothes and shoes do you wear to keep comfortable when hiking?